Hello, I am Yiğitcan Ölmez. I am studying mechanical engineering at Ege Üniversitesi. In this video, I will try to inform you about nanotechnology and carbon. We can see the contents of the presentation here. First of all, what is nanotechnology and the story of nanotechnology? Usage areas of nanotechnology. Secondly, what is carbon? Carbon nanotube, types of nanotubes. What is nanotechnology? Nanotechnology plays an important role in today's world and developing technology. If we take the most basic way, we can define nanotechnology as working with materials at the rate of 1 millionth of the meter. Nanotechnology can also be defined as nanometer scale structures formed by the combination of atoms and molecules. Nano, which is a prefix in ancient Greek, means dwarf. In nanotechnology, it means one in a billion. It's also used in other fields as part of scientific skills. Two words come together to reveal the concept of nanotechnology, which is working with a billionth of a meter. Nanotechnology provides the production, design and control of new materials with the help of nanoscale structures and components. Many properties of the engineering materials used are due to their internal structure at the micrometer level. The superior properties of nanoscale materials are due to their structure 10 or several hundred times smaller than the micrometer. Quantum properties come to the fore when working in nano dimensions, and this offers the material superior properties. The story of nanotechnology. The concept of nanotechnology was introduced by the famous physicist Richard Feynman. The idea and concept of nanoscience and nanotechnology was brought up by physicist Richard Feynman in his French titles, There is Plenty of Room at the Bottom, at the American Physics Society meeting held in California Institute of Technology long before the term nanotechnology emerged. In a speech, Feynman spoke about the existence of a process that scientists can control each atom and molecule separately. About 10 years after this talk, Professor Naru Taniguchi broke the term nanotechnology to the world after his innovation in the field of ultrasensitive process. Nanotechnology gained a foundation in 1981 with the scanning of each atom by scanning tunnel microscope. In the early 1990s, researchers led by Richard Smalley at Rice University developed fluorine molecules in the shape of a soccer ball, obtained by symmetrical ordering of 60 carbon atoms. The molecule obtained was 1 nanometer in size and stronger than steel, lighter than plastic, and electrical and heat permeable. These researches received the Nobel Chemistry Award in 1996. In 1991, one of the Japan's NEC firm researchers announced that Smoljuma found carbon nanotubes. Carbon nanotubes are a staging form of the fullerene molecule and similarly had important properties. Nanotechnology helps people to understand the age atomic length molecularly. Scientists' main goals are to make more robust materials by using nanotechnology. Of course, nanotechnology will continue to advance in line with regular knowledge and research. We will see that material is thinner, smaller and lighter enter our lives, the nanomaterials will increase. Defense industry. Textile comes first in this area, Then communication and sensing systems. The steel waste produced today are doped with carbon nanotube and are 10 times stronger than steel, yet lightweight. Nanoelectronics and computer technology. There are important developments in computer architecture and design with the production of electronic circuit element on nanoscale. Storing data at nanoscale has gained a special importance today. Aviation and space studies. For robots and space shuttles produced for space studies, it's necessary to use high strength materials due to both weight and the condition in space. Using materials and devices produced with nanotechnology offers solutions. Heat resistance, nanostructured couching and nanoscale devices are used for rocket and space stations. Medicine and health. Proteins, nucleic acids, and carbohydrates can be counted as nanomaterials due to their size and arrangement. Gene studies have gained great importance today, so it is estimated that the difficulties of this work can be overcome with nanoscale devices. In addition, another application is to notify with a sensor that it's placed inside the body in vital diseases. What is carbon? Carbon is one of the most common elements found in nature. The carbon symbol is C, and it's a chemical element with the atomic number 6. It's in the 14th group in the periodic table. It's found in nature in its pure form, in the form of graphite and diamonds. The carbon bonds of graphite are very weak and those of diamond are very strong. They are allotropes of the carbon atom. In the reaction of graphite and diamond with oxygen, the same chemical reaction takes place. When it burns, carbon is bound to oxygen and carbon dioxide is formed. The geometrical structures formed by the arrangement of the atoms of the same element differently in space are called allotropes. Carbon has three allotropes: diamond, graphite, fullerene. Diamond. It has a crystal structure. Each carbon atom is applied to four other carbon atoms. It doesn't conduct electricity. It's slow before reacting. Melting and boiling point is high. Glass cutter is used as stone sculpting. It's valuable because of its optical properties. Graphite. Carbon atoms are connected to each other in a two-dimensional plane, forming large, flat plates stacked on top of each other. It's a good lubricant. It transmits electricity. It's used as an electrode in batteries and electrolysis. Fullerene. Carbon also has artificial allotropes. These allotropes are commonly called fullerene. The structure of the fullerenes resembles graphite, but it's not in layer like graphite. The fullerenes are composed of a layer where carbon atoms can be arranged not only as a hexagonal but also pentagonal or even heptagon rings. Carbon nanotube. The fullerene, which is available as a flat plate, is transformed into a tube as a result of studies in nanoscale. Thus, the structure that we call carbon nanotube has been formed. The carbon nanotube is the allotrope of carbon element. Single layer or multilayer carbon nanotubes are available. Carbon nanotubes are used in many products produced with nanotechnology. The cylindrical carbon nanotubes are several nanometers in diameter while their length is expressed in millimeters. Carbon nanotubes, which can reach millions of solid lengths, are more advantageous than other materials with their durability, electrical conductivity and thermal conductivity. When we look at the materials produced from carbon nanotubes until now, it can easily be said that these materials can be used to achieve many dreams in the future. The electronic, molecular and structural properties of carbon nanotubes are stable due to their one-dimensional structure. By changing only the geometric structure of carbon nanotubes, nanotubes with different physical and chemical properties can be obtained. The most important features are chemical reactivity, electrical conductivity, optical activity, and mechanical strength. It's known that carbon nanotubes, which can only be as thick as a hair strength when 50,000 come together, are 117 times more durable than steel and 30 times more durable than Kevlar used in bulletproof vests. In experiments of flexibility, it was discovered that carbon nanotubes can be stretched up to twice as long without breaking. Carbon nanotubes consist of pure carbon atoms like coal, graphite and diamond are even more durable than diamonds because of structure of their chemical bond. Types of nanotubes. 1. SWNT. It means single-walled nanotubes. 2. MWNT, it means multi-walled nanotubes. Single-walled nanotubes. A carbon nanotube is a cylindrical carbon allotrope containing only carbon atoms. We can think of carbon atoms as a curled graphene surface. The ends can be open or closed. A carbon nanotube has a diameter of approximately 0.4 nanometer and a length of about 100 nanometer. Single-walled nanotube is obtained by bending the surface of a single graphene. The diameter of single-walled nanotubes is usually 1 nanometer and both ending are closed. Multi-walled nanotubes. Several graphenes are placed on top of each other and folded and work together. Carbon nanotubes are obtained. These types of nanotubes are called multi-walled nanotubes. According to the embodiment of atoms located on the cylindrical tube, surface work together in the spiral form of hexagonal plates. The electrical properties of these tubes may be of semiconductor or metallic properties. And these are my references that I have used to prepare this presentation. If you want more information about the topic, you can use this. Thank you for listening. Have a good day.